town going through change. I mean, we had the declining industry, glass, coal, that's affected the town in a big way. That was like what the town was built on, effectively. And so that's kind of like fell by the wayside, but there is a lot under the surface, I think, in terms of St Helens, in terms of like the people. The art is, I think, is kicking off now in St Helens, and I'm just happy to be part of that. I'm pretty much self-taught in terms of what I do. And I've been like late to the game in terms of what I've been influenced by in the art world. Pop art, particularly like artists like Roy Lichtenstein, Andy Warhol, Peter Blake. It stands out to me because there's a message to it. The use of comic book art, imagery and things like that, or famous people. I find it really interesting. The show is kind of like a celebration of that, but also a celebration of St Helens as well, of like a snapshot of my growing up. Being my first show, it was obviously exciting and nervous. The fact that it's in my hometown as well, it kind of eased me into it a lot more, particularly because a lot of the support that I've got over the last year or so to make something that everyone in the town can either relate to and just see how proud I am of where I'm from and what the town does have to offer. I live within earshot of the old Knowsley Road Stadium where St Helens played. Now, even from a young age, I was into like sci-fi and monsters and things like that, but they terrified me and I should have probably stayed away. But whenever the crowd cheered at Saints, whenever a try went in and I was in the back garden, I was convinced it was King Kong climbing Pilk's Head office and I'd be swiftly inside and locking the doors behind me. When I was a kid, every Saturday afternoon, my granddad would bring me into St Helens. There was a toy shop called Toy and Hobby. Every weekend I would buy a Star Wars figure. But then I've put the St Helens slant on it as well by making a figure of Johnny Welly, who's a local homeless guy. The Hope Centre, they do a lot for Johnny, so made the figures of him, and then all the proceeds will go to the Hope Centre. I'm hoping the overarching thing would be that I'm kind of proud of where I come from, but also it means home to me. So the different characters that I've included in the exhibition, the different kind of like stories and myths and references and things, it's all stuff that I've grew up with. That's what St Helens is to me. It's like, it's just people with stories to tell.